Welcome back. When it comes to protecting your kids from food allergies, two new studies have some doctors doing a 180, changing exactly what they tell parents. Dr. Andrew Bird from Children's Medical Center is one of the top food allergy specialists in the country, joins us this morning. Thank you so much for being here. The number of kids with food allergies still on the rise, and we still really don't know what causes them?
Exactly. We don't really know why kids are having more food allergies, but I think this new study does lend some evidence to ways maybe able to prevent this increasing number of kids with allergies.
Yeah, so the big study that really has, at least you opening your eyes and double-checking this, basically when we had our daughter, we were told, don't give her peanuts, eggs, fish, to wait a while, almost till she was a year old, just to check. To see if they're allergic to it. This new study really is saying to expose kids early, right? Like really early.
Right. There's been evidence for the past several years looking at populations to understand if earlier introduction may be better. But this study is the first one to actually do that. So to take some kids at higher risk of having a food allergy and then giving them food like peanut early and seeing if they develop allergy or not.
And we're talking, I mean, these kids that were in this study, they're between 4 and 11 months old, and 80% less likely to develop a peanut allergy by their fifth birthday, those that were exposed to it. So this is pretty big.
That's right. It's really a stronger recommendation that hopefully will change the guidelines that pediatricians are using now to tell families when to introduce foods.
So you think they'll change the guidelines because of this one study?
I think that there's a lot of evidence that has suggested this is the right thing to do for the past several years. And so in 2008, actually, the guidelines were lessened, whereas we didn't say anymore, you know, you need to wait till you're 3 to introduce peanut, for example. So that was taken away. But now I think this new evidence will suggest an even stronger statement needs to be made that earlier introduction may actually be beneficial.
Okay, there was another study that I read in Time Magazine. It was published in the Journal of Pediatrics just recently, and it basically said kids who wash dishes, it leads to fewer allergies. Basically the same thing, saying if you're exposed to something at a young age, the chances are your body will kind of develop an immunity to it.
Right. This study deals more with the hygiene hypothesis, which has been around for about 20 years, looking to see if introduction of actually bacteria in the environment is more beneficial. So this is more of an observational survey that says, hey, maybe something as easy as dishwashing by hand might be beneficial.
I know you've been working on a peanut patch for those kids that have allergies, trying to figure out how you can cure them of having the allergies. What do you tell parents if they're not sure if their kid has an allergy or not?
Yeah, it's important to see your physician, have an evaluation if the history is suggestive that there may be an allergy present. Have your allergist involved to do some testing and really get that question answered.
History meaning like maybe one of your other kids has an allergy or you yourself has an allergy.
Right. If your kid has eczema, has another food allergy, or if someone in the family has a food allergy, go ahead and ask that question and get it checked.
Best of luck. Okay, we'll be looking for those new guidelines soon. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thank
Appreciate
you.
It. Coming up here on